There is one thing that may be the last one to cross your mind when you are designing your home studio, but it may very well be the biggest problem you face when everything is said and done. And no, I am not talking about studio gear, recording techniques, or acoustic treatment. Can you guess what this may be?
It all started with the first live session we did here in the studio when it was built. It was clear at once that I neglected one of the most important pieces of equipment, and that was the stands. We simply didn't have enough, especially ones that could go high and support more weight like video lights at the same time. So I looked for the best budget solution, and that was without a doubt these Superlux overhead stands. They are very affordable, of course, they cost almost as much as a regular mic stand, and they have proven to be very durable over the past 2 years that we have used them. But of course, there is a catch. In order for them to be able to go as high as they do and still carry heavier loads, they have to have a big footprint. And that became a problem very quickly when we had to do some live recordings and filming at the same time here in the live room. Although it works, it was a clunky solution and one that made the already not so big room feel very cramped.
First of all, if you are renting out your space to any other musicians, expect to do a lot of this. A lot of setting up and tearing down the room each time a different project comes through the door.
Now, my ultimate goal for this room is to have most things ready to go so that you can get into recording without spending so much time on setup, especially for the stuff that we usually do here.
And I can tell you one thing, those cabinets don't get any lighter as time passes.
We had already found a solution for the vocal space using a wall-mounted microphone arm, and this kind of showed us the way. The obvious choice for video lighting and overhead microphones was to make something that goes on the ceiling.
Eh? I realize that this may come out as if I'm complaining or something, but I'm really not. The point of this video is to show you just some of the stuff that goes behind the scenes when you are recording or making a video for that matter.
That's where this beautiful piece of metal comes into play. Bill, the other member of No Trip Studios, also works as a metalsmith and was able to make this 3.5 meter long bar that we could then attach to the ceiling in a very professional way, I might add. So far, this has gone far better than I hoped. I can have microphones and lights set up and ready to go at the press of a button. And all that without any huge stand taking up precious space here in the room. Now, the only two things left to do is first to find a way to have the cabinet microphone set up without stands, maybe with one of those clamps that go on the cabinets. I have to try stuff out, and also do proper cable management so that we don't have cables dangling in the middle of the room. So if you are in a tight space and you can't fit the things you need in your home studio, look up and you might find the solution to your problem. Thank you very much for watching, my name is Dalam and I'll see you in the next one.